The house is made up out of six pods built on a plot overlooked from all sides. What I realized is that the pods were going to be quite small, and I felt that we should try and tie roof and walls together so that the scale works, because it's quite a sculptural composition and you want the sculpture to read. I was looking for something that would give me a uniform finish. I was quite open to it being a coloured finish. The usual aspects of longevity were important, the fact that it needed to be malleable so that you can work it well. I was keen to go back to the simplicity of it almost being like a hut. That sort of all seemed to work quite well by using a standing seam material. We investigated different materials. You know, you start off with zinc. But what I was worried about is that it would look very grey and drab. And then we also looked at other alternatives. With copper, what I was worried about is that it would age differently on the different surfaces. So in sort of scanning all the products that were out there, I came across this green coat product, a material made out of Swedish steel, and that sort of ticked the boxes. These days, we have to think about all the components that go into a building. Swedish steel uses very little scrap in their manufacture of steel, so it's a very pure steel, which is very resilient to corrosion. It's got a coating, and the base of the coating is rapeseed oil. That's the alternative to fossil fuel oil, and because they use this rapeseed oil, it's completely biodegradable. The six pavilions are completely different in their geometry. There's hardly a right angle in this project, and with the steel we could tailor it to fit like a garment. Each unit could be clad, and the malleability was a real advantage in achieving the finishes that we were looking for. You can see, you know, how it folds round in the eaves and in the valley gutters. What I'm fascinated by is the resilience of this coating. It's actually remarkable because you can bend it as tight as you will and it won't crack. There's a choice, I'd count six or seven or eight different colours. It's got a nice sheen to it, but it's a very muted, earthy colour. And what it allows us to do is to tie this whole development together. I really like the fact that you have these seams at regular intervals. It's sort of like a pinstripe, and it gives some life to the surface, and it changes throughout the day as the shadows change. The other thing is we made it work out exactly with all the openings of the house. The doors and the windows, they're always on a seam. So there's an aesthetic that the material imposes on the project, and we sort of tried to work with it and take it through all aspects of the design. Sometimes think, you know, about arte povera, the sort of idea of doing away with any accoutrements and just letting something rather bare be the finished item. Therein is a beauty, to limit yourself in that way.